Tamam. Get ready. Madam, I now come to the activities of oil exploration. Our aim ultimately is a complete stoppage of import of crude oil. With a view to do so, we are now intensively carrying on oil exploration both offshore and onshore in the country. As the House knows, the activities of offshore explorations are increasing and there are very good prospects of getting oil. Next year, we hope that production from the offshore will be something between 1 million and 2 million tons of oil by the middle of the next year, or by the next third quarter of the year, our production of crude oil from the onshore areas is also likely to increase by about 1 to 2 million tons. So, just now, when we are importing about two-thirds of our consumption, we hope that by the end of the next year, this proportion will be substantially reduced. It is quite possible that we may then produce about 40% of our crude oil by the end of this year and import about 50%. If discovery of oil and production program goes on like this, within 3 years, we hope the situation will very much improve. By the end of next year, we hope we shall be able to produce as much oil as we would require. Madam, such a situation in the exploration is due to the fact that the Oil and Natural Gas Commission has of late made rapid advances towards new technology both onshore and offshore. I am glad to inform the House that we are now knowing much more the difficulties of oil exploration than what we know about a few years ago. We do not hesitate to exchange knowledge with those who have it, although there are sometimes difficult in bargaining with such parties who know more about it than us. Now, with regard to increasing the number of refineries, it is very difficult just now to commit the government to anything like this. There are two refineries in Assam. A third one is coming up. With these, we hope to process as much crude oil as will be possible for us today. We are already committed to transport 2 million tons of crude oil to Bihar. Madam, I would like to say a few words about the Assam oil situation. Oil exploration in Assam is giving, and I want to assure honorable members that both the refineries are being expanded. At present, we are actively engaged in planning for the expansion of these refineries. The petrochemical industry is being planned, and we hope in the next 2 or 3 years there will be sufficient expansion. Madam, there is one more point which was raised by my honorable friend. I want to inform the House that the public sector units are increasing the quantity and quality of our medicines. These are badly required. The House may be aware that very recently there was acute scarcity of blood pressure medicines. These tablets were neither available in our country nor are we getting it from the Western countries. We managed to get the bulk product, and now you will be glad to know that the public sector is producing blood pressure tablets. In this manner, we are increasing our sphere of activity. The honorable member will agree that how soon we acted on the information supplied by him. Further, fertilizers prices have already been reduced by about 80 rupees depending on different types of fertilizers. there is a large program of having plants under public sector fertilizer industry. With the discovery of oil and gas in Bombay High and elsewhere, the position of fertilizer production in public sector has eased. So far, we have been depending on fuel oil, coal, and also some quantities of naphtha for producing fertilizer. We did not want to import furnace oil and naphtha for our fertilizer plants, as more oil and gas are expected to be produced from Bombay High. We hope it will be easier and cheaper for us to produce fertilizer. We hope to get as much oil, gas and oil from these prospective areas as is possible, so that by the end of the next year we may be able to have 8 million tons of fertilizer for our people. Madam, I have nothing more to say. I only hope that this program, which is initiated by the Prime Minister, will receive very serious consideration, not only from our party but from opposition parties also. So far as our party is concerned, we are very serious engaging in modifying our own organization, bringing about improvements in our own organization, creating a new pattern and cooperation between the government and the people to move faster to satisfy the aspirations of the people of India. Sir, I am privileged to move this resolution that seeks the consent of this House for constituting an Environment Adoption and Migration Fund. In submitting this resolution for the consideration of this House, I have been primarily prompted by several considerations, the most dominant being that there is an inadequacy of understanding of what mitigation and adaptation in terms of the budget that the cast on our society is going to really entail, and that the existing structural mechanism which we have is clearly inadequate to meet this huge burden. Therefore, I think there is the need for innovative approach which is based on benchmarking with best international practice, and India must brace itself to deal with these consequences of global warming and climate change. Sir, climate change, as we know, currently poses the most challenging, significant, afflicting millions around the world. Therefore, seeking the creation of a non-lapsable corpus to create an environment mitigation and adaptation fund, because conventional means of financing are inadequate and will remain inadequate. I have been prompted by six main considerations. In fact, climate change can be more worse than conventional expectations. Most of the uncertainty about the impact of greenhouse gases on climate change is due to uncertainty of the climatic parameters. Sir, the impact on India is very serious. I would like to broadly concentrate on four kinds of impact as far as India is concerned. One of them has deeper impacts. The first and foremost is the impact on the water supply, on reduction of water supply, on the massive reallocation due to changes in monsoon patterns. Changing monsoon patterns will affect a dramatic way the location or habitat, our entire civilization pattern with which our entire ethos have grown.